Joining in. First up, if you could clarify a few numbers for us, what exactly is the total hydrogen peroxide domestic capacity and what is your capacity in hydrogen peroxide?
All right, the total capacity on 100% basis is 111,000. You can double it for the calculating 50% because we add water to make it double.
Okay.
And out of that, Gujarat Alkali has 40,000. 100%. It becomes 80,000 if it is taken on 100%. This is 40,000 is 100% basis.
All right. And Mr. Gera, when you're talking about 80,000, that's on 50% and 40,000 on 100% basis, yeah, that's including, you had some capacity that was coming on stream as well, that has been included as well.
No. We are, that is a year late still.
Okay.
March 18 or little about that time, we should be able to put some 14,000 on 100% basis more.
Okay. All right. 14,000. All right, sir.
Mr. Gera, how much of hydrogen peroxide is imported right now and what is the price differential between imported hydrogen peroxide and domestic?
Now, imports currently on 100% basis are about 20,500. That's the data we have with us.
Okay.
20,500. And the price-wise, if you look at the price from Bangladesh, is $370. And Pakistan was $415. Thailand, these are indicative prices. You see, you can't absolutely tell you that this is the final price. They're always bargaining, you know.
Correct.
So, indicative price from Thailand was $390, Korea, Taiwan is around $400.
Correct. All right. So, Mr. Gera, just to understand that right, imports currently, they constitute close to around 20% of the domestic demand. Are we getting that number right?
Oh, yes. Little less than 20%.
Little less than 20%. All right. So, that's the approximate number. And the second question, sir, that I have is, you've given us rates of imports coming in, you know, the prices in other parts, other countries. Domestically, what is the price currently of hydrogen peroxide?
We are selling, our quote is around 33,500.
All right, so we could do
as, as against,
yeah,
as against $370, if we add, now with anti-dumping, the price with anti-dumping would become the 30,000 in Bangladesh price would be around 29,000 to 30,000 in between somewhere. Pakistan price will be 32,000, little above 32,000. And the Thailand price will be around 28,000 to 32,000.
So, Mr. Gera, what is
29, 32? So, and we are selling at 33,000.
All right. So, you're saying in terms of pricing, that will not make a big difference. The benefit that comes out for a company like yours and other hydrogen peroxide producers in our country is that, in fact, the imports will come down. Is that what you're trying to say, sir?
We sincerely hope that imports will get affected. You know, sentiment in the market is important. You know, we producers feel moved that, yes, we are on the right direction and we have installed, we have invested huge amounts in the country.
Okay.
And these the countries are the Bangladesh, Pakistan, they're their neighbors. You know, I mean, one doesn't feel about competition, but when they start dumping, at below their pricing, you know, then it becomes a problem.
Mr. Gera, before we let you go, if you could tell us a couple of numbers. One, how much of your revenue comes from hydrogen peroxide? And with this anti-dumping duty in place, you say there won't be much difference as far as price is concerned. How would this change the picture for the company as far as revenues are concerned? How much comes from hydrogen peroxide and how does this change going forward?
I mean, look, hydrogen peroxide is a, revenue-wise, you're asking.
Revenue, yes, sir.
Total revenue.
Yeah.
Total revenue will be about 12 to 14%.
Okay.
The revenue our company makes from hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen is a byproduct that we produce. And we use this hydrogen in our caustic soda process. Hydrogen is produced, you know. And we have put up this plant. We are competitive because it is a byproduct with us.
All right, Mr. Gera, very quickly then, if you could tell us, two players, National Peroxide and Gujarat Alkali, you all account for around 60-65% of the market. I think imports are around 20%. The remainder, is it unorganized? I ask this because, you know, GST will be... Yeah, tell us, sir.
No. Third company, HOCL.
Okay.
Which is not a very big player, but third big player is HOCL, which is... HOCL's capacity is about 5,225.
Correct. Okay. So GST doesn't have a big play. I mean, have you got the GST rates? So we're just asking that, sir, because it's a topical question.
Sorry, I didn't get GST. GST will have the role on all products, whatever it is there. I mean, GST remains neutral to us
All right.
From the point of view of the number that has been
fantastic
for us.
All right.
That's another problem.
All right.